Hello everyone, welcome to LOTOS Channel. We have one great episode of the 5 episode of the basic roll forming design. Don't lose it. Please focus here. We want to teach you something that none of the company in the world ever teach you. We want to step by step teach you how to design roll forming machine. 5 episodes we prepare for you and step by step we publish in YouTube. Number 1. Develop a cross-sectional drawing. Number 2, we teach you how to calculate the estimated strip width. Number 3, we teach you how to draw the bend progression or flower pattern. This is really important. We teach you how to draw the flower pattern. Number 4, we design tooling and we teach you the how to design tooling by software, CATIA software. Number 5, we going to finish the machine by incorporate the fixtures, guides, side rolls, and a straightening device. So today, we going by number 1, develop a cross-section drawing. Let's start it. Don't forget to subscribe it and wait it for next week, second episode. Let's do it. This is the sample profile the customer bring to us. And the customer need as same as this profile, so we start to measure the each point by measuring tools, whatever you have, the edge, the width, the height. We have to measure it and route it here. You can see all we measure it here. We also have a CAD drawing from customer, but for making sure, sometimes the customer also send us the sample as well. I show you the here. Let me make it 0. This is the height is 75 millimeter and the width is 80 millimeter. You can see here is 80 millimeter. So this section is new for the customer and he needed a different punch, different forming. As you can see here has some shape, small shape forming. The width is almost 15 millimeter. You can see, and in the end also in the bottom it has also other small forming here that we rotate the size here. So from here we go to software and explain to you how we design and draw the cross-sectional drawing. Thank you. Okay, I start the CATIA software and I go to sheet metal design. As you can see, generative sheet metal design. We using the sheet metal design for draw the sections. We name it rack palette and start the view. So now I should put the thickness and radius to start my design because all of my command is not working now. First of all, the sheet metal design, we need to put the material thickness, yeah, and the default bend, as you can see. Okay, my profile I wanted to show you is mirror by middle, so I just draw it half for you today. I start by here, 7.5 millimeter. And what I'm drawing today is the inside sheet section. Then later we can extrude it by outside. The first R is 4 and the secondary is reduced by 2 millimeter. And then we have one line here, we make it horizontal. Okay, make it a little fast for you because these parts is simple for everybody that knows CATIA. Later you can make it stop and learn how we do it. The height is 2 millimeter because number 1 is 4, number 2 is 2. Once we deduct it, it becomes 2 millimeter. And here, 7.5, and the secondary one should be connected together. We trim the left part, and here's 2 millimeter. I show you
zoom it back, and we're going to next step. From here, we just put it a line here. Now we don't know the size. In the end of the drawing, I show you the size of this height. Just the R, what we wrote it here is 2. In this profile, we don't have, but the R is 2 millimeter. And after that, we have two radius again. One is the 1 millimeter, other one is 3 millimeters. Here are the beads. Let me fix it by 38, because after adding 2 millimeter sheet thickness, it become 40 millimeter. Now we're going to making the other two our size. 1 here, first thing, 1 is 1 millimeter, secondary 3 millimeter. We make some circle here, trim the left part, and one more time, 3 minus 1 become 2. So here it should be 2 millimeter, and 2 minus 1 is 1 millimeter, so we can move it up and down. Now we don't fix it and go a little high. One more time, same. It's the same continuous alignment. 1 radius is 3 millimeters, other one is 1 millimeter here. Okay, we trim the extra part, and now here we have the size is 13 millimeter. Other size later, I show you how I put and how I measure it. Just let's go to next level. I make it simple that you can design any section that you want. Yeah, by any angle you can make some line. Later we put the angle here, the R, 2, and here is 22. It's 2 millimeter, the R is 2 millimeter, and we go to next one here, same, the R fillet is 2 millimeter. Okay, because we designed the inside line, it should be 4 millimeter here, 8.5 millimeter. So now we should fix the height. The total height is 73, because after we added 2 millimeter, it becomes 75. Now it's 73 millimeters. So here it should be 32 millimeter, and take it a little down. From this small size, I don't have here in my PDF, but I have in my software. I should check it in my software and change it by here. Let me open it, because I already draw it and complete it. And here we put the size by, show you, let me find the other profile for you. Yeah, here. Okay, I measured it here. Let's pay attention. It's 4.35 and 5.35. Okay, now we go to drawing. The down part, we make it 4. Yes, 3.5, and the up part 3.5. Oh yeah, exactly. Okay, and now we're going to check the angle. this angle to this angle. You can see the angle radius, and we're going to change our profile here. Yes. Okay. Other part, I think, is correct because it's the same as the customer drawing, and we are the drawing. It's somehow going to finish. Let me check. Yeah, and now it's time to mirror it and complete our drawing. Okay, start comment mirror, and you can see it's all fixed. And it's now time to make it the extrude 2 millimeters thickness dimension. Yeah, this is the what we going to make the machine for this profile. This is the first step, how to design the section by Katia. So simple. Please watch this video several times. You will learn it by Katia. And this is the all my sheet metal must be unfolded from here to other sides, almost 245, and this is the final after punching. Don't forget to subscribe us, because we have also the other video to show you. And don't forget to follow us here. I'm showing you one more time the bits of the sheet metal and our holes punching. In next videos we will explain to you how to design and how to make the punching dies tooling for our forming machine. I hope you enjoy and learn something from this, the first episode of the roll forming machine design. And if you have any further questions, feel free to contact us. We mostly using Katia because it has a complete command for us. Feel free to contact us. If you like this video, please subscribe. Thank you. Bye.